be your protection, yeah, I'll be your protector. Hey.
Opportunities
to fade, shade, and downgrade will provoke you. And those you trust will start to turn to.
So
never pay too much attention to the things they say they won't do. And you gotta be persistent. And believe me, you won't see much. It's just the beginning.
More of this stuff is standing. Howdy, hola. Invite and share. It's gonna be real, real good.
Because you hold it like. You hold it like. You hold the light and it's shining and making darker places brighter.
You light up. You hold the light.
You bring the light. You bring the light and it's shining and they can see it. They won't end it, but it's not for the taking. It's not for the changing, though. It's not for remaking. It's not for remaking. All right. So they line it up to take it. All right. I can let them take my youth. You know I ride for you.
God bless you.
I won't let them take you.
You're gonna love this. Hey, Staten Island, hey, Crochet Passion. God bless you. Greetings from Philly. How we doing?
Yeah,
amen, amen.
You know I ride,
amen. I'm going to miss them, too.
I'm
going to miss.
I'm fighting because I refuse to lose you.
There's no need to worry about them let me downs. You can count them and stink the moment you let me round. I torched it. Screenshotted and forced it to move off that groove and made on the porch of your heart. I knew from the start it was gonna be wars. The clowns we fight for. The thought of you free from danger.
I'll tell you in 1 second. It's easy from New York. I'm about to turn the music down. I'm just rocking right now, letting everybody get on. Hey, from Fort Hood. You can get Jock Cook on iTunes. Hallelujah. Amen. Let me turn it down now. Amen. God bless everybody. We're going to do this meditation and then keep it moving. Somebody had asked me about the Lamb song. That was Julie Meyer. Julie Meyer, you can get Julie Meyer. You can actually look at her on YouTube. It's a song called Unto the Lamb. Unto the Lamb. And it's on YouTube. Jacques Cook, you can get him on iTunes. Hey, hey, hey. Get him on iTunes. Hey, hey, God bless you. God bless you. Better and better. Hey, Cat on the Roof. We doing good. We doing good. All right. I want everybody, if you don't mind, to turn to John 16, verse 13. I've been hearing a lot of words. Praise God. Oh, from Tokyo. Wow. God bless you, Tokyo. I don't know any words to say in Japanese, but yeah. Oh, Ichiban. I know that. Ichiban. Jesus is Ichiban. I guess that means number one, right? Jesus is Ichiban. Hallelujah. North Kakalaki is in the building. What it do? All right. Yeah, welcome, Tokyo. Wow. Wow. All right. If we could look at this scripture, and I have a very interesting, I finally found some of my stuff. It's John chapter 16, verse 13. John 16, verse 13. And for the record, I'm not homeless. I know I'm in different environments every time you see me, like I'm in a different environment today, or I'm in my car, but no, I'm not homeless. Somebody said they thought I was homeless the other day. Because I was always in my car. That is so funny. Hallelujah. Yeah. I'm always on the move, so you know. Uh-oh, now we about to pray about that. Because that ain't cool. That ain't cool. You see, you need to start a GoFundMe for me to get home. Yeah, Cat on the Roof, we got to pray about that, for real, because, yeah, that shouldn't be. So you're going to really be blessed after this meditation today. This is actually going to give you some revelation on that, okay? So let's go to John 16, verse 13, without any further ado. And then we're going to prophesy. All right, I got 4 people I think I wrote down from my email to do. And so we're going to get to them. All right. John chapter 16, verse 13, it says, "Howbeit when he, the Spirit of truth, is come, he will guide you into all truth. For he shall not speak of himself, but whatsoever he shall hear, that shall he speak. And he will show you things to come." I'm going to say that again. "Howbeit when he, the Spirit of truth, is come, he will guide you into all truth. For he shall not speak of himself, but whatsoever he shall hear, that shall he speak. And he will show you things to come." I'm reading the King James Version. And so what this scripture is saying is that the Spirit of truth, which is the Holy Spirit Jesus is referencing, he says when he comes, he will guide us into all truth. Think about that. He will guide us into all truth. But think about the intimacy of this. "He shall not speak of himself, but whatsoever he shall hear, that shall he speak." So in other words, you all, whatever the Holy Spirit is hearing the Father say, that's what he's going to tell us. But not only is he going to tell us that, it says he will show us things to come. So as we were meditating on our expected end earlier, the Lord will show you that expected end. He will show you the things to come. He will show you your future. Amen. The Holy Spirit will. You don't have to go to a psychic for it. He will show you the things to come. It's very, very, very refreshing. So we never have to worry. You know, sometimes we get a little stressed out and we're wondering. And when we ask the Holy Spirit, he'll tell us. And I'll be the first to tell you, there have been times where I would hear the Holy Spirit clear as day. But sometimes it sounds too good to be true, so I don't want to believe it. I'm like, nah, that's got to be me. I'm so serious. Man, I'm very transparent with y'all. Be like, nah, that's too good to be true. Like, it just can't be that. And then it ends up being exactly what he said it is. And then more. All right? So this verse is really going to help us as we meditate on it. But we're also going to talk to the Holy Spirit too. Okay? Now, because I'm in a different environment, and these speakers that I have playing are a little challenged, so to speak, I'm going to change what I was going to play and put on something that I know would sound cool, even if it's still coming out of these speakers. All right, so I'm going to throw Mr. Jacques Cook back on. Okay. Oh, praise God. Thank you for that. I appreciate that. All right, so let's begin to get into this, okay? John chapter 16, verse 13. Hey, what's up, my bro? Hit me up, man. I've been, emailing you. Yeah, you're the one I've been rapping to on the email, without question. Without question. All right, are you all ready? So remember, when we meditate on the word, we haggah. Haggah means to mutter, imagine, study, and ponder. So we're going to ponder as we are muttering this particular scripture. We want this scripture to be written on the table of our heart as we communicate with the author that is behind this living word. This word is literally living, okay? So Jesus is the word. We are about to communicate with Jesus himself. Okay? Are we ready? Amen. Yeah, these speakers are a trip, for real. All right, so here we go. We're going to meditate on the part, he will guide you into all truth. Okay? So let's begin to say that, realizing that it's the Holy Ghost that is the He. So let's begin to say that now, nice and slow, okay? Holding on to every word. He will guide you into all truth. 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 Hold on, we're going to make it personal in a minute. Right now, I want the word to become engrafted on our hearts, to break down that hard exterior. He will guide you into all truth. He will guide you into all truth. Remember, you're talking to your soul now. This is your spirit talking to your soul. Tell your soul, He will guide you into all truth. He will guide you into all truth. All truth. He will guide you into all truth. All truth. Hallelujah. Now let's begin to make it personal now. Or more personal, I should say. We're going to change the He to you. All right? You will guide me into all truth. You, we're talking to the Holy Ghost now. You will guide me into all truth. You will guide me into all truth. All truth. You will guide me into all truth. You will guide me into all truth. You will guide me into all truth. Now let's begin to say this part now. Let's make it even shorter. Let's say, guide me into all truth. 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 I want you to ponder what all truth means. Imagine being led and directed into all truth. Let's begin to release some revelation on guide. You will lead me into all truth. You will direct me into all truth. Yes. Matter of fact, we're going to do something a little different. Let's make it present right now. We're going to release revelation for guide, but we're going to say it right now as an actual action. You are instructing me into all truth. You are guiding me in all truth. You are directing me. I am being directed into all truth. There it is. Let's say that. I start off with the I. I am being directed into all truth. All of us are yielded to the Holy Spirit, right? So that means this is what's happening. I am being guided into all truth by you. Yeah. I am being drawn into all truth by you. Let's say by you at the end. I am being led into all truth by you. Yeah, let's get vulnerable right now. Come on. I am being led into all truth by you. I am being moved into all truth by you. I am being exposed to all truth by you. Yeah. I am being exposed to all truth by you. Yeah. I am being guided into all truth by you. Wow. I am being surrounded in all truth by you. Man, this part right here, you all, like, I'm sorry, we just gonna stay right on this part. We could come back to the other part, like, on another day. I was gonna do just one scope tomorrow, man. But this part right here says a mouthful. You are guiding me into all truth. Now let's begin to take the all truth, because remember the truth is, praise God, the truth is not our truth, it's God's truth. Sometimes our truth isn't his truth. So let's begin to speak to him about that. I am not in the dark. You are exposing me to all truth. I will not worry because you are guiding me into all truth. I will not be scared, for you are guiding me into all truth. I will not be hesitant, for you are guiding me into all truth. Say that thing in the beginning. If you want to put it on the screen, you can. If it's too personal, just say it wherever it is you're at. If you're around people, you can say it under your breath because you're muttering. Okay? So I'm just saying something that I won't be, for the simple fact he's guiding me into all truth. Okay? So I will not be scared because you are guiding me into all truth. I will not be afraid because you are guiding me into all truth. I will not think I know it all, for you are guiding me into all truth. I was just about to say that and I looked at the screen and saw it on the screen. I will not be prideful, for you are guiding me into all truth. I will not be doubtful and deceived, because you are guiding me into all truth. Oh, these are good, you all. I will not be manipulated. Yeah, because you are guiding me into all truth. Ooh, yes. Man. I will not be insignificant, because you are guiding me into all truth. I am not ashamed, because you are covering and guiding me into all truth. Yeah. I will not be tormented, because you are guiding me into all truth. I will not be cast aside, because you are guiding me into all truth. I will not be insecure, because you are guiding me into all truth. I will not be bound, because you are guiding me into all truth. I will not be put down, because you are guiding me into all truth. I will not be deceived, because you are guiding me into all truth. Yeah, that deceives. Come on, I'm gonna say that again. I will not be deceived because you are guiding me into all truth. I will not be alone or lonely because you are guiding me into all truth. All truth. I will not be bound or put to shame or unapproved because you are guiding me into all truth. And remember, just because I'm saying the ones, you don't have to say what I say. Whatever you feel strongly in your heart you should say, go ahead and say that to the Lord. It's you and Him. Hallelujah. Some of us might want to say the same thing over and over again to Him. Do it. All right? Allow that thing to come and really penetrate your heart. Till you just feel the total fullness of that thing. And cling to it some more. All right? I will not be denied because you are guiding me into all truth. I will not be lost because you are guiding me into all truth. I will not be rejected or poor because you are guiding me into all truth. I will not live in fear because you are guiding me into all truth. I will not worry that I don't have the answers for certain things. Because you are guiding me into all truth. I'm sorry, I gotta say that one again for myself. Some answers I'm looking for some things coming up with me. I need some details, you know, some dates, some certain things, some endeavors I'm embarking on business-wise. I will not worry that I don't know the exact date or dates. Because you are guiding me into all truth. Yeah. Yeah. Now another part of meditation is, you know, we don't have to be monotonous. We could just go with the flow. So it was like I just started feeling the flow for myself personally, just to say, guide me into all truth. You guide me into all truth. You guide me into all truth. You guide me into all truth. All truth. That means I'll know, Lord, when you want me to know. Because you guide me into all truth. Do we realize what we're really saying? All truth? That means we're not going to be manipulated, deceived, even if somebody is lying to us. The Lord is going to guide us into the truth of it. You will guide me into all truth. Yeah, this is good. Wow. You are guiding me into all truth. Now you all know what? I just thought about something about guiding into all truth. That means those prophetic plans. What are those plans or desires that you have in your heart that you want to do for the Lord? Think about it. And as you begin to pray about it, have the confidence that the Lord is guiding you into all of the truth of that thing. He's guiding you into it. So He's connecting you, whether it's with the people, whether it's the situations, whether it's the needs that you have for that particular thing. He's guiding us into all truth. This is good. Wow. Yeah, that's good. That's right. What are those things? Let's say those things, you all, that we know the Lord told us to do, or that the Lord, or those dreams that we have. All right. What are those dreams? Begin to speak those dreams or those things the Lord told you, but you might be doubtful about. Because that person just kicked it off when they said, I will prophesy because you will guide me into all truth. Ooh, yeah, there we go. I will not worry about my family because you are guiding me into all truth. I'm going to release personal things myself too, okay? I will walk in my authority because you are guiding me into all truth. I will finish this album and be successful with it because you are guiding me into all truth. I will get all the means that I need, all the finances that I need, and all the connections I need because you are guiding me into all truth. I will not compromise my faith because you are guiding me in all truth. I will let you use me to heal the sick because you are guiding me into all truth. Yeah, these are good. I will continue to love you because you are guiding me into all truth. I will have a spiritual warfare ministry because you are guiding me into all truth. Oh, yeah, those test results. That's right. Say that for yourself. Yeah. Wow. These are powerful. You all are releasing. Wow. Helping the homeless. Yes. Yes. Yeah. Release these, you all. And if it's too personal, you don't have to put it on the screen, but still say it. Speak to your soul. And all of creation is going to align. You're going to start divinely connecting with these things. You're going to start getting certain ideas out of the blue. Yes, you are guiding me into all truth. Oh, wow. This is good. Yes. Yes. Oh, wow, these are good, you all. Wow. I can hear, I can like hear just the openness, just the raw intimacy and honesty of what it is you all are putting on the screen. I can't even explain it. That's why I'm just being quiet, just allowing you all to speak. I'm going to have to, I'm going to have to cut this short because my phone is about to die. So what I'm going to do is, you all can keep meditating. I'm going to go put my phone on a charge and I'm going to come back on because I said there were four people that I needed to prophesy to. And they already know, they hit me up on the email. We're about to do it. I just need to go take my phone and put it on a charger. Wow. This was powerful. You all can keep meditating though. All right. I'm about to come back on. We're going to release those prophetic words. Other than that, God bless everyone. I'm going to come on one time tomorrow because I got a lot I'm going to be doing tomorrow. So I'm going to come on early tomorrow morning one time, probably around like 9 or 9:30. And that'll be it. But yeah, God bless you all. Yeah, if you need prayer, that's cool. Just come back on. I'm going to put my phone on a charger. And since I'm prophesying and praying, I can drive while I'm doing that, you know. So I don't have to really look at the screen, except at a light or something, you know. I don't know. We see what it do. God bless you all. I love you. Okay. Bye-bye.